I was just a kid from Bolton. I got in this band called The Wanted. And then travel the world, it was absolutely incredible. I've got everything I wanted. I've got money, I've got fame. So I'm very proud of where I've got to in my life, to be honest. I own a lovely house, got a beautiful wife, amazing kids. What more do you need?
So go, Daddy! Cheer! So keep walking.
So this time a year ago, I felt absolutely normal, totally fine. And then I started saying to Kelsey, I don't feel right, and I couldn't quite put my finger on it.
We went to Norfolk and we was in this cottage right on the river. But I remember Tom just being quite like snappy about things. Tom's not like that as a person. He was then having this seizure. Obviously, it's horrible seeing anyone go through that, but I think when it's your husband, it's like the worst thing. Then the paramedics came and they checked him over. They were like, yeah, he'll be out in 4 hours. And he wasn't.
Yeah, so obviously because of the COVID situation, I was just on my own in Norwich Hospital. And they came in, pulled the curtain around, so you've got a brain tumour. I was like, I can't have. You've got to have made a mistake. I'm 32 years old. When you get told news like that, I just remember just shutting down. Just didn't want to acknowledge anything to do with brain tumours, cancer. Just couldn't think about anything. Also, I just remember just thinking, am I going to die? So a glioblastoma is, it's a brain cancer. There's different levels and different stages of glioma, essentially. And I've got the worst one. Great.
But the whole time Tom was actually in hospital, I could not stop shaking. As soon as I picked him up and he walked out of the hospital, obviously, he just broke down into tears. And I was like, I can't cry in front of him.
Kelsey has been literally a rock of support for me.
You're going to be fine.
She's taken the world upon her shoulders, bless her. I can't even imagine what it's been like for Kels. Potentially being left with two kids to look after as well, like...
Here he goes, old Insta-dad. Look at Daddy! Yay!
Going public was a massive, massive discussion within the family. Ultimately, I knew that for Tom, it was the best thing.
People have been so lovely. Reaching out, and I think when you take strength and courage from other people around you, that really helps.
He has been so, so strong. I'm more proud of him now than I am for anything else he's done.
The kids are the one reason to get up in the morning. They bring that positivity out of me. And if I'm gonna fight for anyone, it's gonna be for them and for Kels. They need me. And I need them.
He's played in front of millions and millions of people, but he has dealt with this situation like an absolute superhero.
Puts life into perspective. I think that's what it does ultimately. You know, nothing's ever guaranteed. Tomorrow's never guaranteed for anybody.